This service, we use this opportunity to appreciate our Lord Bishop, the Right Reverend Dr. Emmanuel Oludayisi Adekunle and Mama Eba for the opportunity given us in St. Andrew's Anglican Church, Kajala, to conduct this service. The opening hymn for this service is hymn 144. Church of Nigeria hymn 266. Lord our God, belong mercy and forgiveness. Though we have rebelled against him, neither have we obeyed the voice of our Lord our God, to walk in his law, which he set before us. Rend your hearts and not your garments, and turn to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and compassionate, long-suffering and ever constant, ready always to relent when he threatens disasters. Jesus said, whoever will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. We have come together as family of God in our Father's presence to offer him praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive his holy word, to bring before him the needs of the world, and to seek the forgiveness of our sins, to seek his grace, and through his Son Jesus Christ, we may offer ourselves to his service. Let us confess our sins to Almighty God. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. Let us in silence examine ourselves before the Almighty God. Let us confess our sins to God. Let's say after me, Almighty God,
Almighty God,
our Heavenly Father,
our Heavenly Father,
we have sinned against you,
we have sinned against you,
and against our neighbors,
and against our neighbors,
in thought,
in thoughts,
and word,
and word,
and deed,
and deed,
through negligence,
through negligence,
through weakness,
through weakness,
through our own deliberate fault,
through our own deliberate fault,
we are truly sorry and repent of all our sins,
we are truly sorry and repent of all our sins,
for the sake of your Son Jesus Christ,
for the sake of your Son Jesus Christ,
who died for us,
who died for us,
forgive us all that is past,
forgive us all that is past,
and grant that we may serve you in newness of life,
and grant that we may serve you in newness of life,
for the glory of your name,
for the glory of your name.
Amen.
Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you.
Amen.
Pardon and deliver you from all your sins.
Amen.
Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness.
Amen.
And keep you till life eternal.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouths shall show forth thy praise.
O Lord, make peace to save us.
O Lord, make peace to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
The appointed psalm for this service is Psalm 51. It shall be read alternatively. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions.
Wash me from my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sin.
For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me.
Against thee only have I sinned, and not this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest.
Behold, I was shackled in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me.
Behold, thou died truth in the inward part, and in the hiding part thou shalt make me to know wisdom.
Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow.
Make me hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice.
Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out of all my iniquities.
Praise in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Cast me not away from the presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit.
Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee.
Deliver me from God's business, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of thy
righteousness. O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise.
For thou thy sacrifice, hence will thy give it, thou lightest not in burnt offering.
The sacrifice of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. O God, thou wilt not despise.
Do this in thy youth, and
the last verse shall be read together.
Then
shalt thou be the sacrifice of righteousness, with burnt offering and all burnt offering. Then thou shalt be offered workload upon thine altar.
Thank you. The only lesson for today is taken from the Epistle of Paul to the Romans, chapter 3. We commence reading from the 9th verse. What then? Are we better than they? No, in no wise. For we are before proved both Jews and Gentiles, that they are all under sin. As it is written, there is none righteous. No, not one. There is none that understandeth. There is none that seeketh after God. They are all gone out of the way. They are together become unprofitable. There is none that doeth good. No, not one. Their throat is an open sepulchre. With their tongue they have used deceit. The poison of herbs is under their lips, whose mouth is full of cursing and bitterness. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We continue in this service as we sing hymn 155. To hear your word. Father, we pray, will you speak your word into our lives, that our life may be transformed.
Amen.
We pray in the name of the Father,
Amen.
Hand of the Son,
Amen.
Hand of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Today, Sunday, the third Sunday in Lent. We pray that As we turn in this season of Lent, I pray the Lord will bless each and every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The text for this sermon is Romans chapter 3, verse 10. Romans 3, verse 10. As it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. The topic of this sermon is the universal sinfulness. Universal means worldwide. It means something pertaining to the universe. Romans chapter 3, verse 10, that says, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. The book Romans is the epistle of Paul to the Romans. This epistle was written by Paul to prepare the way for his visit to Romans. He wanted to visit the Roman church, and he saw the need to write to them about his own view and understanding about Christian faith. In this book, Paul developed a theme, the whole human race. He talked about the Jew and the Gentiles, the need for them to repent. Because the Jew, they saw themselves as someone who is closer to God than any other one. From the preceding verses and the preceding chapters of chapter 3, he admonished the Jews, telling them that as they claim they are closer to God, as they claim they are the owner of God, which is Yahweh, they also, they have to repent of their sins. That is, they have to have a new life in Jesus Christ, as the Gentiles will also do. He talked about the human race, that every man has sinned, that every man who is born of woman has sinned and has a time to repent and must repent of that sin and must be washed and be cleansed from such a sin through Jesus Christ. In the passage read, Paul was talking about the need for salvation for everyone in the whole world. He showed that both Jews and Gentiles have sinned and forfeited all rights and titles to God's favor. He said affirmatively that there is no righteous. This means there is no one that is righteous, that has a clean heart, considering the soul of man. God himself is represented as looking down from heaven to see if there were any that feared him. He looked down from heaven and he couldn't find any. Paul said, they have all gone out of the way. No one does good. Their mouth is full of poison, cursing, and bitterness. The sinful nature of man and the nature of human being can simply be traced to the fall of man in Genesis chapter 3, that Adam and Eve fell, betrayed, and they fell in the Garden of Eden. This sin that Adam and Eve committed is the sin that has been transferred into us, into the human race. When they had children, the first children, they also committed this sin because they share in this corrupted nation. That was why Cain killed Abel. And in Psalm 51, verse 5, David said, behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. The sinful nature of man is that nature in man that made man to commit sin. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 20, Solomon said, surely there is not a righteous man on earth who does good and never sin. Jesus Christ also confirmed this when he said, if you who are evil know how to give good gifts to your children, he said, if ye who are evil Jesus used evil to call the human race. That is, to explain the human nature, that is the sinful nature in human being. Saint Augustine also said, inherited mortality is the penalty of original sin. Children of God, all have sinned and come short of God's glory. But God does not want the death of a sinner. This is why this message is coming to us today. That no matter the gravity of our sins, no matter the gravity of the sin you've committed, God can save you. The sinful nature of man that is in us is what makes us to commit sin. But Jesus Christ has come into the world not to condemn sinners, but for sinners to be saved. This is not coming to you to strengthen your sinfulness, but for you to repent. That sinful nature in you, in human being, is what makes us to sin. But when you come to Jesus Christ and surrender our life to Him in genuine repentance, the whole nature of sin will be removed and He will put on us the nature of Christ, which is the new life. It's another time for us to repent or to rededicate our life to Christ. Children of God, the wages of sin is death. Not this first death, but we are talking about the spiritual death. As been recorded in Romans chapter 5, verse 12, and 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14. And another thing is eternal condemnation. I pray this will not be our portion in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen!
What can we do to live above this sinful nature? The first thing is to surrender our life to Christ and live a new life. And the second thing is to allow the Holy Spirit in our lives and to allow Him to direct us, to direct our path, to direct our ways. And the third thing is to walk with Christ. Children of God, this is the right time for us to do so, because procrastination is the thief of time. Let that old man, which is the sinful nature, go out of our life today. And we put on the new nature, which is the nature of Christ. Are you thinking that your sin is much to the extent that you cannot be forgiven? This is a good news for you that the Lord is calling you today to have mercy upon you and to forgive you. If you totally surrender your life to Him and repent of your sin, allow Jesus Christ in your hearts today, and you will bear good fruit, which are the fruit of the Spirit. The fruit recorded in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. Every evil in human nature will be replaced with good work, which are the fruits of the Spirit, if we surrender our life to Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ came into the world not to condemn sinners, but to save sinners. Not to condemn you and I, but to save us. That sin that you have seen in your life that Jesus cannot forgive, He can forgive you. And this is time for you to repent your sin, and you will be saved. And the new nature, which is Christ, will be put upon us. And I pray, as you do so, the Lord will bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen!
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, we thank you for the word you've sent to us. Father, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we pray. Give us grace to repent of all our sins.
Amen.
In the name of God the Father.
Amen.
Of the Son.
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Ede kiafi towo towo jewo otito igbagbo wa. Igbagbo.
Oba Ola Oba Ede Kumaribo. Ede Kumaribo. Ede Kumaribo. Ede Kumaribo.
Ya Rabbi, I think that I'm so. as he is God's people.
Amen.
Ki Oluwa ki o pelu yin.
Ki o si pelu emi re.
E je ki a gbadura. Oluwa saanu fun wa.
We si saanu fun wa.
Oluwa saanu fun wa adura Oluwa.
Baba wa ti n be ni orun. Ki a bo foruko re. Ki ijoba re de. Ife ti eni kan se ni aye. Bi wa ti n se ni orun. Fun wa ni ojo ojo wa lori. Yare ise waju wa.
Ni àlàáfíà ní ìgbà tiwa Olúwa. Sọ kọ wa di mímọ́ nínú wa Ọlọ́run. Àdúrà. Ìkíní tí ń ṣe ọjọ́ ìsinmi kẹta. Ọjọ́ ìsinmi kẹta ní Lẹ́ntì àti àwọn àdúrà mìíràn. Ọlọ́run Olódùmarè, àwa ń bẹ̀bẹ̀ lọ́dọ̀ rẹ, síjú wo ìfẹ́ àtọkànwá àwa onípamọ́ ọmọ ọ̀dọ̀ rẹ, kí o sì na ọwọ́ ọ̀tún ọlá ńlá rẹ jáde láti ṣe ààbò wa lójú àwọn ọ̀tá wa gbogbo, nítorí Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa.
Àmín.
Olódùmarè àti Ọlọ́run ayérayé, ẹni tí kò kórìíra ohunkóhun tí ó dá, tí ó sì ń darí ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ di gbogbo àwọn tó ronú pé wàdà, dá ọkàn tuntun sínú wa, kí o sì fún wa ní ìròbínú jẹ́ ọkàn. Kí àwa ti ń pohùn rere ẹkún ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ wa bí ó ti yẹ, tí a sì ń jẹ́wọ́ òṣì wa, kí a sì lè rí ìmúkúrò ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ àti ìdáríjì tí ó pé gbà lọ́wọ́ rẹ. Ọlọ́run àánú gbogbo nípasẹ̀ Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa.
Àmín.
Ọlọ́run ẹni tí ń ṣe olórísan àlàáfíà tó olùfẹ́ ìrẹ́pọ̀, mímọ́ ẹni tí ń ṣe ìyà ìnípẹ̀kun àti sísẹ́ ẹni tí ń ṣe òmìnira nítán, láàbòbò wà wo nípa ọmọ ọ̀dọ̀ rẹ ní gbogbo ìkọlù àwọn ọ̀tá wa. Kí àwa ẹni tí ń gbẹ́kẹ̀lé ààbò rẹ gidigidi, má bẹ̀rù agbára ọ̀tákọ̀tá. Nítorí agbára Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa.
Àmín.
Olúwa bàbá wa ti ń bẹ ní ọ̀run, Olódùmarè àti ayérayé Ọlọ́run, ẹni tó ti mú wa dé ìwúrọ̀ ọjọ́ òní ní àlàáfíà, fi agbára rẹ̀ ńlá dábòbò wá nínú rẹ̀ náà, kí o sì fi fún wa, kí a má ṣubú sínú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ lónìí, kí a má sì sórí wọnú ewukewu, ṣùgbọ́n kí gbogbo ṣíṣe wa kí ó lè máa ti ọ̀dọ̀ rẹ là lẹ́sẹsẹ wá.
Amen.
Kí a lè ṣe èyí tí ó tọ́ lé ojú rẹ nígbà gbogbo.
Amen.
Nítorí Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa.
Amen.
Ọlọ́run Olódùmarè, ẹni tó ti fún wa ní olùfẹ́ nísinsìnyí láti wá fọkàn wá bẹ̀bẹ̀ lọ́dọ̀ rẹ, ó sì ṣe rí pé nígbà tí ẹni méjì tàbí mẹ́ta bá kọ́ra ọjọ́ ní orúkọ rẹ, ó fi ìbéèrè wọn fún wọn. Olúwa, mú ìfẹ́ inú àti ìbéèrè àwọn ọmọ ọ̀dọ̀ rẹ tí ó ṣe nísinsìnyí, ní yóò ti lè pè fún wa jùlọ. Máa fi òtítọ́ rẹ fún wa ní ayé yìí àti ilé ayé tí ń bọ̀, iyè àìnípẹ̀kun. Gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹbí kan ni òkísẹ́ kájúmọ̀ gbàdúrà orí ọ̀fẹ́. Orí ọ̀fẹ́ Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa, ìfẹ́ ti Ọlọ́run àti ìdàpọ̀ ti ẹ̀mí mímọ́, kó máa bá gbogbo wa pé títí láéláé. Amen. As the choristers will be leading us in choruses, we bring our tithe and offering. And those of us at home, let's send our tithe and offering to our various churches through the banks of our churches. I pray as we do so, the Lord will bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oliwa mi mo dupe, mo dupe, mo dupe, mo dupe. Oba sori ni e.
Oluwa mi mo dupe.
Mo wa dupe ore.
Oluwa mi mo dupe.
Mo wa
heaven, we pray that you bless us and our offering. We pray in the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for this opportunity, for this, to be in this service for today. Lord, we pray as we go, you go with us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Bless us and bless everything concerning us.
Amen.
And the peace of God that passes over understanding,
Amen.
Keep your heart and mind
Amen.
In the knowledge of God.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty,
Amen.
The Father,
Amen.
The Son,
Amen.
And the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
Be with you
Amen.
And remain with you
Amen.
Now and forevermore.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We use this opportunity to appreciate every one of us. And we pray that the Lord Almighty will bless us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We appreciate once again the diocesan, the Right Reverend Emmanuel Oludaisi Adekunle, PhD, and Mamayoka for this opportunity granted unto us. We appreciate the lay leaders, the choristers, the organists, and every one of us, the members that have come. We pray the Lord will bless you.
Amen.
The Lord will keep you.
Amen.
And make his face to shine upon you.
Amen.
The closing hymn is hymn 591. Sort of Nigerian hymn now. 590.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Father, as we go, you go with us.
Amen.
Bless and keep us.
Amen.
Dismiss us with your peace.
Amen.
For we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Oh,